A very good morning to my dear students. Welcome back to English Grammar online class. Students, this is the video for class 4th, English Grammar, lesson number 27. And the topic is comprehension. So let's start today's class. Students, in this video, first we will know the meaning of comprehension. After that, we will solve the exercises. So before starting this topic, we should know what is comprehension. So students, let us start today's class. Open chapter number 27, page number 121. So let us discuss the meaning of comprehension first. See students, comprehension means the ability to understand. What does it mean? It means the ability to understand. Reading comprehension is an exercise that trains students to understand a language. Okay, so comprehension means the ability to understand. And reading comprehension is an exercise that trains students to understand a language. So we can say that comprehension is an exercise that tests how well you understand spoken or written language. So it means the ability to understand. So what we are having a paragraph or stanza. Related to this stanza, we are having some questions. So we have to find out the answers of the questions from the given paragraph. Reading comprehension. So let us try to solve the first one. Here, suppose you are having this paragraph. The aeroplane is a great modern invention. It can cover long distances in a short time due to its high speed. It has helped to bring people around the world much closer. The aeroplane was invented by the Wright brothers. There are mainly two kinds of planes. Passenger planes carry people, whereas cargo planes carry goods. An aeroplane has a large body. It has two large wings and a tail. It is the fastest means of transport known to mankind today. So as you have seen, you have a paragraph here and the paragraph is related to aeroplane. In this paragraph, we got some information regarding aeroplane, that aeroplane is a great modern invention. Who invented aeroplane? What kind of planes are there? Like this. So now, with that, we are having some questions and the questions are related to the paragraph. You can find the answers in the paragraph. So this is very must. This is must, that reading the paragraph is must. First, you should read the paragraph. You should understand the paragraph. Then only you will be able to find the answers and you will be able to solve the answers of the given questions. So as we have seen that this paragraph is related to aeroplane, and this paragraph we have seen about the aeroplane and some other things. So now let us see the questions. What questions are there about related to this paragraph? Like here, first question is here, why is the aeroplane a great modern invention? Why is the aeroplane a great modern invention? So when you have read this paragraph, that stanza, you must have read this also, that why the aeroplane a great modern invention. So it is a great modern invention. Why? Because it has helped to bring people around the world much closer, because it covers long distances in a short time due to its high speed. So we can see that aeroplane is a great modern invention. So you can write this answer. The aeroplane is a great modern invention as it has helped to bring people around the world much closer. Second question, who invented the aeroplane? If you have remembered the paragraph, you have read the paragraph that who invented the aeroplane. This information was also there in the paragraph. Yes, Wright brothers. The Wright brothers invented the aeroplane. So you can write the answers. As I have told you that if you read the stanza carefully, you will find all the answers in that stanza only. So reading of the paragraph, understanding of the paragraph is very important in the comprehension. Now let us see the next question. How many kinds of planes are there? So there are mainly two kinds of planes in the paragraph. We have studied about two kinds of planes, passenger planes and cargo planes. So you can write this answer. There are mainly two kinds of planes, passenger and cargo. The next question is, how many wings and tails does an aeroplane have? This also we have seen in the paragraph that an aeroplane has two large wings and a tail. So what will be the answer? An aeroplane has two large wings and a tail. Now next question is, which is the fastest means of transport known to mankind today? So fastest means of transport, that also we have seen in the paragraph. Which is the fastest means of transport? Yes, answer is aeroplane. So aeroplane is the fastest means of transport known to mankind today. So you can write this answer. See, there is no space in the book, so you will do the paragraph comprehension in your notebook. So open your notebook, write down the question and then answer. Now, exercise B of this paragraph is, write the antonyms of the following words. Antonyms. Antonym means opposite. Opposite of the given word. So, first is modern. So, the opposite of modern, antonym of modern will be ancient. Long. Short. Large. Either you can write small or tiny. Both are correct. So large, small or tiny, fastest, slowest. So these are the antonyms. Antonym means opposite of the given words. So write down the answers in the notebook. So you have seen how to solve the comprehension, how to solve the reading comprehension. Whatever passage is given, read the passage carefully. Understand the passage carefully, what is there in the passage, and then read the question and find out the answer from the paragraph. Now let us try to solve the second one. The modern age is the age of science. Science is the greatest boon to mankind. Modern scientific inventions have increased human comforts and enjoyment. Things which were thought to be impossible in the past are now really happening. Science has revolutionized human life. It has conquered time and distance. Man has landed on the moon due to modern science and technology. Some popular inventions of science include the computer, television, refrigerator, washing machine and microwave oven. So when you read this passage, you must have seen that this passage is related to science. In this passage, we have the information of science. How science is so important, how science is the greatest boon to mankind. And modern age is called the age of science. What science has given us? It has conquered time and distance. So first read the paragraph, read the passage and try to understand the passage. Now related to this passage also we are having some questions. First question is, what is modern age called? So when you read the paragraph, you must have seen that this question's answer you can find in the paragraph. We have the information about this question, what is the modern age called. So the modern age is called the age of Science. Why is science the greatest boon to mankind? This also we have seen in the paragraph that science is the greatest boon to mankind as modern scientific inventions have increased human comforts and enjoyment. Science is the greatest boon to mankind as modern scientific inventions have increased human comforts and enjoyment. So we can see that science is the greatest boon to mankind. Next question, how has science increased human comfort and enjoyment? Science has increased human comfort and enjoyment immensely as it has conquered time and distance. We have seen in the stanza that science has conquered time and distance and invented many useful things. So that's why we can say that science increased human comfort and enjoyment. Next question is, what has helped man to reach the moon? This also we have seen in the paragraph that modern science and technology has helped man to reach the moon. So the answer is modern science and technology has helped man to reach the moon. Next question, name some popular inventions of science. This answer also you can get from the paragraph, from the passage. Some popular inventions of science are computer, television, refrigerator, washing machine and microwave oven. So you can write the answers in your notebook. Then we have exercise B of this paragraph, this passage. Here also write the antonyms of the following words. As I have already told you, antonyms, the meaning of antonym is opposite of the given words. So antonym means opposite of given words. So here you are having some words, increase, decrease. The opposite of increase is decrease. Popular, unpopular, impossible, possible, past, present, include, exclude. So write down the opposite, write down the antonyms in your notebook. Antonyms means opposite. So the opposite are given here. You can write the answers in your notebook. So you have seen when you read the passage, paragraph carefully, you will find all the answers in the paragraph. So reading is must, reading is very important and understanding of the passage is very important. Now one more paragraph, just you try to solve it. This is your home assignment. This paragraph is, first you read the paragraph and find out the paragraph is related to which topic. What is in this topic? What is in this passage? Okay, so read the paragraph, understand the paragraph carefully. And after that, read the questions related to the paragraph and exercises. Okay, so that's your homework. You will complete it. You will get the PDF for cross-checking, but later on, first try to solve by yourself. So I think comprehension meaning and how to solve the comprehension is clear to you. That's all for today's class. Thank you and have a nice day.